the history of our particular quest over the last 125 years, I'd like to dispel some of the myths about federal recognition, what it means and what it doesn't mean. The first one of those is that federal recognition does not create an Indian tribe. Federal recognition of an Indian tribe is very much like federal recognition of China. It's a political relationship that is established, a relationship that is created, but the relationship is created only because that self-governing people that is recognized long existed before the establishment of that government-to-government relationship. So when the United States recognizes an Indian tribe, they don't create an Indian tribe. They don't establish something that didn't exist before. They merely recognize the fact of the long pre-existence of that self-determining Indian people. So what is the hallmark then of an Indian tribe that is recognized? And how does that come about? It is simply this. Indian sovereignty means the will to exist. It doesn't mean that the federal government creates you and makes you an Indian tribe. And you don't hold sovereignty as an Indian tribe because the federal government recognized you. To the contrary. You hold sovereignty as an Indian tribe because your people made a self-conscious decision that they would continue to exist despite the fact of the dominant society's presence and occupation of the territory that was once theirs. It is that act of will as a people that is recognized when you are recognized by the United States. So let's keep that in mind. We're not creating anything. The United States is simply acknowledging something that has always existed. The opposite of that is also true. The converse is also true. Just because you are not federally recognized does not mean you are not an Indian tribe. I can take you to reservations 4 hours drive from here that has existed since 1677 by virtue of a treaty with the British Crown that has never been recognized by the United States, but they continue to operate and survive by that same exercise of will that the Lumbee tribe has. This is the Pamunkey tribe in Virginia. The Pamunkey tribe is on their same Aboriginal territory they have occupied since 1677. That's remarkable. There are other reservations like that, most on the East Coast, none of which have federal recognition. Does the absence of recognition mean that they are not an Indian tribe? Obviously not. They are there and they exist. It's the federal government's fault that the federal government has not recognized that fact. So we have to remember that. It just so happens that most of the non-federally recognized Indian tribes today, of which most people believe there are approximately 100, are located on the East Coast. And there's a good historical reason for that. The federal government, as we know it now, was formed in 1789 upon the adoption of the United States Constitution. By that date, most of the tribes located on the Eastern Seaboard had been dealing with the dominant society, with non-Indians for 100 years at least, many 150 years or longer. Because of that interaction, most of those tribes had already lost all of their tribal land. The last evidence we have of tribal land of the Lumbees dates around 1730s. And the same occurred with most of the other tribes on the East Coast. The colonists had already taken their land long before the United States adopted the Constitution and formed in 1789. In addition, most of the tribes on the East Coast, again, because of the long history of interaction, were already pacified, had already established peaceful relations with their non-Indian neighbors, sometimes by treaty with either the British Crown or with the colony. But because most were peaceful and had already lost their tribal lands, the United States felt no need to deal with and thereby recognize those tribes. In other words, it's nothing but an accident of history. If we had had something that the federal government wanted in 1789, believe me, the federal government would have recognized us in a treaty so that they could get whatever it was they wanted. And that's what happened in most treaties. There was an exchange. exchange, a session from the tribe of land, peace, war, whatever it was the United States won, that went from that tribe to the United States. And whatever they were able to reserve in that treaty became the basis of the ongoing relationship between that tribe and the United States that was established by that treaty. There was no policy of the United States to seek out and recognize by treaty or otherwise every tribe they could find. Not at all. Only when the United States needed something in particular from a particular tribe did the United States undertake to establish a relationship with that tribe and thereby recognize that tribe. So it's purely by accident of history that the tribes on the East Coast who lack federal recognition do not have that recognition. It wasn't until 1978